Hey guys, it's Carrie with Viewership, and today I'm going to walk you step by step through how I optimize videos in YouTube Studio Beta. So we are in our YouTube channel, and we are in YouTube Studio, and what we want to do, we're at our dashboard, we want to go down to our videos, and today I'm going to show you how I optimize. We're going to optimize this video about creating custom thumbnails. So if we go ahead and click on the title here, that will take us into the back end and we can go ahead and start optimizing this video. So first thing I like to start with is the advanced tab. We'll click on the advanced tab and I want to upload subtitles and closed captions. So what I've already done, we use a transcription service called rev.com. I have had them transcribe our video and I've downloaded the files. Now I'm going to upload the SRT file to YouTube. So I'm going to click on upload subtitles without timing. Go to my downloads folder and here's my SRT file that I've already downloaded from Rev. Click on open. And then it shows me that subtitles and closed captions for original video language are English. They've been uploaded by me. Okay, so I'm going to click save here. And then I want to manage other languages and I'm going to go to transcriptions. And this is my process. You can work through these steps any way you like, but this is just how I get from point A to point B. So we're going to click add language. And the languages we like to translate to are French, German, Russian, Spanish, and Portuguese. So I just clicked on add language. I'm going to start typing the first couple letters for French. Press enter. Click on add language. German, press enter, add language, Russian, Spanish, and Portuguese. Okay, so it queues all of the languages up for you. And then you can click on either up here, you have title and description. Well, we haven't written our title and description yet, so I'm not going to mess with those. What I want to do is focus on subtitles. So on this French row right here, I'll click add and it's going to open another window. I go back to my original tab. I click add for German. I click add for Russian and it's opening up different windows. And again, this is my process. I've kind of learned how to do this quickly over the years. All right. And now we've got our window for the French subtitles. I'm going to click on create new subtitles. And then there's a drop down over here, auto translate. Click on that drop down and click auto translate. And while that's populating, I'm going to go to my next window, create new subtitles. This takes a second, so I just like to kind of hop through the windows. Now I'm in Spanish, Portuguese. Go back to my French tab. It's already auto-translated in French. German, I'm gonna click the drop-down, auto-translate, let it do its thing. Russian, Spanish, and Portuguese. Okay, so French has been auto-translated. I'll click Save Changes. I'll go to my next tab. German, it's been translated, save changes. Russian, save changes. Spanish, save changes. And Portuguese, save changes. And then you'll see that it's populating. It's letting us know that they're done with Russian. Portuguese is still loading. Let's refresh our page. These are still publishing. Let that work for a little bit. I'm going to let's refresh it over here. Published, 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 published. Perfect. Okay. So we've got all of our subtitles loaded, all of the different languages translated, loaded, published. All right. Next thing we're going to do, go back to, click out of here, go back into our video, click on advanced again, and let's check the advanced tab. All right, so we've got our subtitles all loaded. Everything looks good on the advanced tab. I'm going to go back to the basics tab. Okay, and what I want to do here, we need to add our recommended tags, so our keywords, and we're also going to take a look at cards and end screens. So let's go ahead and take a look at our end screens. So we'll click on this pop out here. And again, end screens are cards that show up on the last 20 seconds of your video. You can see that down here. This gray area indicates the last 20 seconds of your video. So you can't pull them out any further or longer than the last 20 seconds. So I'm going to import from my last video, how to edit videos. Okay. So it pulls up the same cards that I used on the last video. So it'll look the same. It'll look similar. Let me mute myself here. All right. And this is just showing us a preview of what these cards will look like on the last 20 seconds. And these are clickable cards. So at the end of your video, if your viewers want to check out some other videos that you've created, or if we click on this playhead, or subscribe to your channel, you've got all those buttons ready for them. And if you want to change any of your cards, you can go ahead and click the edit button. You can change to a playlist, which let's just do that so I can show you how that works. Click on save. And then your playlist shows up right here. So those are your end cards. We'll click save. Always remember to click save. All changes are saved. Okay, and this is a pop-out window. So if we go back to our next window. So we've done end screens. Next, let's take a look at cards. So again, this will open up a new tab for you. And I like to add at least two cards. One is a poll. And my poll question will be something about thumbnails, since this video is about creating thumbnails. So do you create custom thumbnails? This popped up because I've used this question before. And then I'm going to give you, the viewers, the option to type in yes, no, or not yet, but I'm learning. And the great thing about polls is that it encourages engagement from your audience. So it's nice. And you can find out more about what people want. And then I'm going to add another card towards the end of the video. I typically like to add a playlist. Or if I'm talking about something specific, I can add in that particular video. So there you go. And then these indicate where your cards are showing up in your video timeline. So this is just around 3:30, and this one is about 14 minutes and 15 seconds in. Okay, now we're going to go back to our basic tab under video details, and let's see what else we need to do. Okay, we definitely need to optimize our title, our description, and add our keywords. So what I've done, again, we have all of our videos transcribed through rev.com. And along with the SRT file, they also deliver a text file. So I like to download that text file and then comb through it, pull out the major ideas, and use that as the description. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I'll come back when I'm finished. Okay, so I have created my title. And I've added it here in the title box, and I've created my description. We always like to link out to our website within the first couple lines. So that's viewable when people are in YouTube search. And once I've added those, my title, my description, I'm going to go ahead and add some keywords, the tags down here. So I always like to have our title in here as well. And then there are some recommended tags. We also, I've done some keyword research as well. We use vidIQ. And they will recommend tags for us. So what I'm going to do is kind of look through down here, how to get your video suggested. No, I'm looking for more thumbnail geared tags. So let's go ahead. We're going to add a couple of these. How to make custom thumbnails on YouTube. Yep, that's exactly what we're going for. So with vidIQ, it helps make adding tags quicker and easier. And then you've got your count, how many characters you can have. So just, I'm going to keep adding. And I'll do a more in-depth video on how to do keyword research. But for now, to make this a little quicker and easier, I'm going to use vidIQ. Custom YouTube thumbnail, we're almost to 500. And you just want to max out your tags. Best practice. Why not? And one more. All right, we're at 491. That's perfect. Then we will click save. Okay, and one last thing I want to do before we add in our thumbnail is I want to translate the title and the description. And if you remember, we saw that on the advanced tab here in video details. So to manage other languages, go to transcriptions. Okay, and here we are, title and description. I want to make sure to translate those into all the languages we've already pre-selected. So YouTube Studio does not make this easy. This is something they need to work on. If you go back to, I'm going to cancel out of this because it's way too complicated to do in beta. I'm going to go down here, back to Creator Studio Classic. I'm just going to click on Other and submit. Okay, so here we are in our video in Creator Studio Classic. I'm going to go to the Info and Settings tab. And then here, right underneath our video, is the Translations tab. And again, we use vidIQ, so it populates this little translate button here when we start selecting our languages. So I'm going to select French. Oops, sorry, it's asking me I need to read first. What language is the original text in? It's in English, and that's the default. And I want to translate to French. Add language, translate to. I'm going to click translate, and it'll translate everything for me. Then I click save changes. And I'm going to do that for French, German, Russian, Spanish, and Portuguese. So here we go with German. And this makes it really quick. The other way you can do it, if you don't have vidIQ, is to use Google Translate, copy and paste. I've done it before in a pinch. It works just as well. It's just a little more, well, it's a lot more time consuming. Spanish. And Portuguese. And there we go. We have our five languages translated, our title and description. Perfect. Okay, let's go back to YouTube Studio. And the last thing we need to do is we'll go into videos. And we'll go back into our thumbnail video. Okay, let's just take a look. We did cards, we did end screen, we added our tags, we translated. Okay, now we want to add our thumbnail and go down here to add in our thumbnail. And I created a custom thumbnail for this video. So I'm going to go ahead and click upload. And in my downloads folder, there is my thumbnail. Open. And there it is. Click save. And the last thing I have to do is schedule this video to be published. So I'm going to schedule it. Schedule it for tomorrow. At what time zone? Okay. It's a specific standard time. So I'm going to schedule it for 8:30 a.m. All right, publish as public. I always like to double check tomorrow at 8:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, local time. Done. Okay, and that is my step-by-step walkthrough on how I optimize videos in Studio Beta. Like I said, the translation for the title and descriptions isn't great yet. It's not fully integrated with vidIQ, so I do like to hop back to Creator Studio Classic. If you guys have any questions or if there are any step-by-steps that you want me to create, please definitely leave me a comment. I'm checking all of them. Let me know what you want to see. And if you need help editing and optimizing your video, make sure you go on over to viewership.com and shoot us an email. We are going to be rolling out a beta program soon for YouTube content creators to help them with editing and optimizing. And I'll see you guys in the next video.